So don't you hate it when you finally have time to engage in your hobbies again and you get back to doing what you enjoy and then life punches you in the left facial nerve? Yeah, solid 0 out of 10 experience, would not recommend. But we've got a game, hopefully, to finish this time. And before I do, I was reminiscing during my first week of illness about when I had originally played this game and how I said I ran into a game-breaking bug. I think it might have been that I didn't know to go behind the piano and get the tool. So that might have been on me. And anyhow, no doorknob. Let's go ahead and get right back to it. What am I doing? This? Oh, here we go. I remembered this door, and that's about it. Well, I know we gotta. Oh, I should have let me out. I want to save. Should have probably reviewed my notes on the last session, but here we are. I think we're getting closer to finishing. I don't get the impression that there's a whole lot left. Let's see, what's around here? Plate on the table. A memo with the full course menu written on it inside the book. Starter, soup, fish, gratin, meat, cheese, dessert, coffee or tea. No nuts? I always thought that you ended the meal with nuts, which is why you had the saying soup to nuts. Should I write this down? I should write this down. Probably. Okay. Do-do-do. Starters. Soup. Fish. I don't think I've ever eaten a full, course meal like this. Never really been exposed to high-class dining. But I also come from a culture that's mostly on the family dining side, so big communal dishes. I bet you're gonna have something stupid to say about the coffee and the tea. Welcome, Michel Dardan. I am the maid of this manor. You are invited to Miss Chloe's dinner party. Well, what kind of gentleman would I be if I declined this? Please stay seated until the preparations are complete. Oh, did I go too fast? A. Oofoofoofoo. With this menu. The maid is cooking with a smile on her face. Were you always here? Did you enjoy the dismemberment display? Oh, that's a sanity heart, isn't it? Oh, I knew it. Right, okay, well, we're getting the Yukio Mishima special. My, menu. Finger and tooth hors d'oeuvre, hair salad, heart essence, eyeball marinade, with a blood sorbet and an internal organ steak, with a glob of fat. We have a body fluid tea. What is this? This is disgusting at this rate. Why was my item slot was flashing there? The order is. Oh, glad I copied it. Starters, then soup, then fish. I assume that a gratin is a frozen dessert. And then meat, then cheese, then dessert, and then coffee and tea. We have a squid ink pasta. You're at the menu. Wow, that was really nice. This music is so loud. Miss Chloe, please stay. Oh, okay. Messed up your menu. Okay. Do I get to go out? You know, I didn't even bother checking if the door was locked. There's going to be a banquet. I'm so excited. Great. Okay, Blanc's still here. Y'all don't meow when I pet you. Right. I suppose we'll have a seat. This looks like the right. Lady Chloe's chair. Well, that was rather rude of me. Oh, the seating order. I need to sit down. Yeah, but where? I got a Chloe sprite there, though. Where am I supposed to be sitting? Probably gonna cause you a lot more trouble from here on out. Well, that doesn't bode well. I am sorry. It's fine, I swear. So annoying. Annoying? Sorry, that was a joke. Alright, this is getting the best of me. Okay, I had to make sure that I was actually recording my audio. Could not afford to mess this up. Also, while I was messing around earlier, check this out. You can play this game with mouse, it looks like. That's pretty cool. I didn't realize. Anyhow, let's get that cursor out of the way. I was supposed to approach it from a different side. Yeah, I was never trained in the classics, I'm sorry, but I'm a common man. I will now bring the food. Oh, it's maids A and D. That's who that is. Okay. I think. That's why they have initials. Was there a guide on etiquette? Because, I am boned. Ow. This is so delicious. I think I messed this up. I gotta go back and find that guide. I don't know anything about formal etiquette. Next, we use fish only available here. It is manure. Manure? I don't know what that is. It looks like fish with bones in. Turn over the fish? Okay, you know what? We're not gonna make it through this dinner, guys. I'm sorry, but I don't know what I'm doing. I barely understand the order of, like, how to eat with multiple, forks and whatnot on the table. Horrific stomach pain. I can't eat anymore. Right, well, I died at dinner. I wonder if I'm locked out from going back in the kitchen, because I really need a refresher on my etiquette. Aha! Okay. Take and leave from left. Too good to be true. Do not spread until host has spread theirs. Spread napkin. After host. You know, it may seem like you're telling them to hurry up. Oh, okay. I was keen on moving all my notes to an actual notebook, because I feel like it'd be kind of cool to keep a record of all the different notes that I take while playing these games. I have, like, multiple notepads that have been spread out over the years, and it'd be nice to consolidate them. Napkin, side to mouth. Napkin. How very proper of you. Okay, use your napkin. Eating. Bread after soup and dessert. Oh, after soup and before dessert. Okay. No wonder they sent kids to school just to learn this stuff. Leaving seat, full napkin. Okay. This is quite the formality. Removed bones, With a knife, right?
Yeah.
What, is it improper to bring your own pair of tweezers or something? Leaving your seat. Remove napkin. After host. Dirty side is inside. Okay, left side of table. Okay, lightly full. I was not born for nobility simulator, it seems. Okay, that should be everything, right? Superb. And then this was the menu. Lovely. Alright, ready to eat. I'm gonna say a little irreverent prayer, alright? Chloe, is that fine by you? I will now bring the food. Oh yeah, and I forgot to comment on it earlier, La Campanella. I spread my napkin. Fantastic, my turn. Anyhow, good bread, good meat, good God, let's eat. This is so delicious. Next, we used fish only available here. How do you even pronounce that, manure? I'm worried that I'm saying it too similar to manure. Take out the bones. Well, I've got a knife. Horrific stomach pain. I can't eat anymore. Okay, if I have to leave, and then leave it on the chair. On the left. Okay, we got the light fold. Okay, gonna go vomit real quick. Thank you. I do apologize about the innards. Oh. Do you have the ability to save Chloe? I wanted to confirm that. Oh, we came in here to, express our displeasure with the chef. Even after turning to this, I still worry about Miss Chloe. I've always looked after her. Miss Chloe has become too strong, and it's harder to control her. Please stop praying for my grandfather. He's becoming too strong. She's being tormented by the curse. Please, save her. I can no longer look after her. Okay. Time is of the essence here. Can you get it going? Please take this. Obtain Caprice 24 music sheet. I've never heard of that. With your ability, surely you can rescue Miss Chloe. Please, do what you can. Sure thing! Hey, you! You have to make Chloe's Requiem a reality. Oh, title drop when they say the name of the game in the game! Lovely. So what is... 24... I don't know this song. Take you away, take you away, bring that out. What do you even have this dirty doll for? Right. It makes me happy when you play violin, Michel. That is why I'm happy now. Thank you, Michel. You're welcome. I do not know a lot about talent, but I think you are amazing, Michel. Hey, what do I do with this music? Do I not? Oh man, I should not have written that. Oh wait, no. There's something on the table. An inkwell. Niccolo, oh, Paganini. Capriccio 24. He was a genius violinist. Often said he sold his soul to the devil in exchange for his ability. The song was used for practice. I think I glitched the game. A song said to be the hardest to play on violin. Was Traumary always playing on this floor? I don't think so. Wait, what am I supposed to do now? Are we gonna keep eating? No, we're done eating. Feeling okay? Trouble? Right. I have music. Oh wait, violin. You want a duet? You do want a duet. No, you don't. I have heard this, I think. Michel. Michel, you're amazing. Ahaha, I'm unbeatable. You on that violin, me on piano? Let's perform together a lot. That'll definitely be lots of fun. Did we unlock a hidden memory? Is that what this is? That's not Chloé. Knew it. An 11-year-old child, capable of this. It is hard to believe, even witnessing it with my own eyes. He reminds me of Paganini. I can't even play, yet this child. He must be a child prodigy. He's certainly something. It would be so much better without the piano. I agree, the piano player isn't on the same level either. Well, I think for his age, he's playing quite well. However, when he's alongside Michel, it's a different story. Everyone's a critic. Why does he always have to perform with him? They should just hire an adult. I don't think they can. It's Michel's own wish, after all. I heard that he wouldn't perform without his brother. He threw a tantrum over it, even. Well, he may be a genius. He's still a child, huh? Brother. I guess that was Pierre. They're twins. It makes sense they would be close. Okay. I'm exhausted. I guess it is tiring doing it day after day. I mean it. I don't want to play the violin anymore. Don't say that. Everyone always compliments your violin playing. You heard that, right? No, nothing. I heard nothing. I just felt the strings under... Okay, you're always like this. I'm not interested. I'm like the revolver ocelot of violin over here, apparently. What is it? Are you the new maid? Yeah. Okay, that was taking forever. I am the new maid. Please call me Charlotte. Oh, hello, Charlotte. I should probably finish that game and all the other ones that came after it. Alright, I'm Pierre. This is Michel. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Young master... Okay. Michel. What? Nothing. Nothing at all. I'll be leaving now. I don't get you. I don't know what's going on. There's something weird, but don't know what it is. I see now. What a coy expression on your face there, Pierre. What? Nothing. That girl, she's taken quite the liking to you. What are you even talking about? I live for nothing but violin. Well, it has nothing to do with me, so it's alright. This is gonna be amusing. Can love even bloom in a concert hall? Alright, what bad thing happened? Surely something bad has happened. What is it? Nothing at all, young master. I'm just going to practice. Okay, good luck. Aw, thanks. Are you going back to your work? Apologies. Well, sure. Let's look around. Music sheets and books about music. The clock is silently ticking. I don't think they had invented silent ticking quite yet. A beautiful painting of a plant. This is quite something. But we do have our inventory on us. Nothing to do here. Where is practice? This way? Oh wow. You're finally here, and you're late. This is literally our house. Pierre, how long have you been here? For about 3 hours. Your distaste for practice is affecting me now. Give some thought to me sometime. I just noticed you got a little ponytail. The Elric brothers over here. Well, whatever. We... Charlotte? Huh? Didn't you go back to work? Yes, but, well... Oh, I see. You're going to clean around here. Yes. In that case, pull yourself together. Give the people what they want, a good show. Wow, it got dark. Shouldn't you, like, light a candle or a lamp or something? It's dark already. Should we call it for now? Alright. Not to mention, you are talented, huh? Even though you've barely practiced, you can still play that well. I still need to practice a lot. Well, I'll be off now. Oh, are you gonna leave them in the room together? Oh. Are you not going too, young master? No, I just don't feel like moving right now. Young master, you are amazing. I've never heard such perfect tone. It's nothing. It is amazing. I'm so impressed. Young master, I love your performances. Oh, really? Yeah, really? No way. Well, I'm going to go now. Okay. I see the case for the violin. That's pretty cool. Musical tools. Isn't that orchids? The painting, that is. Bedtime? What is this? What's wrong? Oh, nothing. I've just hit a wall with my studies. You're always so serious, Pierre. You should study too, Michel. The teacher will get mad at you again. Boring. I'll get around to it. That's a problem for future me. Why do something today that you could do tomorrow? You put your mind to it, you do well. Boring. I'm just gonna lay in bed and kick back. Okay, everyday items. Do I actually just kick back? Music washes away from the soul the dust of everyday life. Bertold Auerbach. I think. My bed. What do I even do? Go back outside, maybe? How many save slots do I have? Ah, I got plenty. By the way, how old are you? You don't seem much different to us. I'm 13, and I'm able to work, so they hired me. We invented child labor laws for a reason. He was being cheap again. Who? Nothing. Am I supposed to be in here? Sitting here and face the wall? What's a guy to do around here? Nothing, 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 and nothing. Talk to you again? And yet, you choose not to study nor perform. What do you even plan to do? Just take it easy, life as it comes. I'm going to sleep. It's still early, but alright, good night. Oh, bedtime. Don't tell me you're like, oh, you gotta get in from the left side of the bed. Clearly, I am not going to sleep. What on earth am I supposed to be doing? Talk to you again? Oh, but the night is still young, and whatever. Oh. That seems like a real dilemma. Talk to you again, maybe? Okay. I think sleep. Sleep sounds good. Fairly late for me, but I've had enough caffeine to kill a small animal today, so. Good night, Pierre. Good night, Michel. Oh, I can't sleep. Young master. Whoa. What? Master has called for you, so. You came to wake me up. Alright. Yes. You move aside? Oh, I'm sorry. Did I do something? No, nothing at all. At all. I don't really care, but are you unable to talk clearly? I'm sorry. Dang. Rude AF. Hey, Michelle, you're late. Hey, Pierre. Recently, I've been feeling someone's gaze on me. Like, someone is watching me. That might be Charlotte. She's always hanging around next to you, after all. An astute observation. Don't make that face. She idolizes you. Isn't that cute? You don't get it, Pierre. I wonder if I can change maids. You don't have to go that far. By the way, did Father call for you too? Yeah, you too? Yeah, just before. Charlotte didn't wake you up? Great, well, where are we being summoned to? Oh, this is the parents' room. Some shadowy figures around here. Oh, it's you, Michelle. I've heard the rumors. Oh no, I'm an old friend of your father's. I'm just visiting. Oh, Michelle, good timing. What is it? Yes, well, it's regarding the concert today. I have to do it again? Would you want to try performing on your own? What? You've been noticed a lot. Next time we'll ask for a pro pianist to play alongside you. How about it? No. As I thought. However, the pianist is famous. I will not perform with anyone other than Pierre. But really, you've been noticed by a lot of people. At this rate, we may be unable to ask for other people. If that does happen, isn't that fine? Okay, I'll decline the pianist, even though I was the one who invited them. Is that everything? Yes, it is. I shall take my leave. Roger that. Man, you are everywhere. Oh, it's you again. Young master, do you not get on with the master? Not really. He doesn't even think of me as a son. Huh? He probably thought I was a good moneymaker. This family's no money, after all. And that's not... Come to think of it, how are you being paid for working here? I can't imagine that he's paying you anything. You have it bad, too. That's not the case at all. The master's a wonderful person. Nah, quiet quit. I constantly think about how glad I am to be working here. Is that so? Yes, being able to eat bread twice a day is like a dream for me. I also have a place to sleep, too. I'm so happy that I no longer have to sleep on the floor. That's why. Master's a wonderful person. Young Master Michel, I implore you to get along with Master. Okay. Right. Hey, Michel, can't you do something about Charlotte? I don't want to do anything about it. I mean, I feel bad for her at this point. Why? You don't have to stick up for her so much. What? I wasn't getting at that. Okay, are we practicing then? Back to bed. Ah, Michel. Have a sip of water. Pierre. Oh, you're here. I have something I want to talk to you about. Okay, what is it? So it looks like we're going to be another performance. Could you perform by yourself? Did Father say something? Huh? No. He's always sticking his nose in. Don't talk about your own father like that. Also, by the way, I'm going to be busy that day. I see. Then I won't perform either. Either cancel the concert or move it to another day. Trying to cut us loose over here. This is for your sake, Michel. Even if you perform badly like me, it wouldn't affect you, right? You're talented, so you can't just stay stuck here forever. You need to aim higher. It's crescendoing. Higher, huh? What do I achieve by doing that? Even if I can play well, it's not even fun. There's a lot of dots. Michel, you ask for too much, wanting to play well and have fun doing so. That's wishful thinking. In that case, I don't want to be skilled. If my talent is going to hold me back this much, then I don't need it. Ooh. I'm trying to make a note for editing me. Not to mention, I won't perform without you. I've said it so many times. Yet you never listen. Well, they're gonna have a little sibling conflict over here. You need to grow up already. Honestly, it's getting tough to deal with. It's tough being your twin. What do you mean by that? I get it. It's fine. I need to go tell Father. Uh-oh. Footsteps. Pierre, why is he performing still? The sound. Ah, young master. What are you doing here? I can't sleep. I see, the footsteps were yours. I'm sorry. Say, how long has Pierre been performing in there? Okay, you are not gonna give me the answer to that question. Whoa, we got some ink blots here. The bed is torn. Say what? Pierre. Michel. Have you been performing all this time? Maybe. Can I continue? Wait a moment. What? Something sounds off. Maybe the sound of the piano is off. What? It isn't at all. It always sounds like this. Nope, something's off, I think. Don't touch my piano! What? My piano sounds weird. Oh man. My dude played the piano until he went mad. My piano sounds weird. There's no way it does. I've never noticed it. All the time I've been playing. Is that it? What was it again, perfect pitch? Lucky you. Pierre, what's wrong? All of a sudden, you... All of a sudden? There's nothing sudden about this. Or could it be that you've never noticed that I've been holding back this whole time? I've hit my limit. You're always so selfish and it's always causing me problems. No matter how much I practice, I'm always criticized. I'm always reminded that there's no meaning to trying my best. It's always Michel this, Michel that. You have it so easy even though you're so lazy. Because of you, my parents don't even love me. Brother, I don't think they even love me. And yet, you take everything I want and then attempt to get rid of it. I can simply not forgive you for that. I wish we had never been born as twins. If you weren't here, people would probably recognize and compliment my ability. I wish I was born as an only child into this family. You should go die. What do you mean? What are you even saying? In that case, okay. I simply, absolutely despise you. Even if you apologized, I would never forgive you. Time to go. Where's the front door? Are we hailing a cab? Anything to do around here, or are we just gonna book it? Oh, I accidentally found an actual option. Young Master. Before I could hear Young Master Pierre's voice, did something happen? It's got nothing to do with you. Young Master Pierre said something to you, didn't he? I think you don't have to worry that much about it. He's always talking badly about you. I think he's quite envious. Okay, this is going a little slow. No matter what Young Master Pierre says, it'll never make you any less talented, so... Stop talking! It's fine. Just stop talking. I hate him. Well, cheers to that, I suppose. Tearing this family apart! Why? I mean, you two were always together. I thought you'd be together forever. Oh, don't say that. Those two words in conjunction in a horror game are not good. But it's precisely as Charlotte says. No matter what Pierre thinks, or what I think, the present remains the same. I only have what I don't need. The only thing I can't have is what I want. All I wanted was to be like back then. Was it to be like back then? Those joyful days. I see. Everything is because of that. If I didn't do that, then Pierre wouldn't have come to hate me. Everyone, it's because of this awful instrument, this horrible... A cat's voice? Well, a little kitty. Why is there a cat here? No, oh, it looks like it's comforting me. Good kitty, where'd you come from? I guess they're lost. There! Oh wait, Chloe. I guess I shouldn't give it a name. Though it is a stray cat, it's not like I need permission. But... I wonder if it's happy about that. That's really weird, dude. Chloe. Why Chloe? My pianist tulpa, Chloe. Chloe. Alright, I'll bring dinner later on, so hold tight. Oh, I see you ominously in the background there, Pierre. Oh, it's all gone. I said it's all gone. You're cute, Chloe. I'm just gonna lay down the ground rules. That cat gets hurt, we're greenlit for John Wick, okay? Pierre, I'm going now. Right, well, okay. Where to? What's he doing? That cat can open doors. Chloé, you shouldn't be here. If someone sees you. What do you plan to do? Are you gonna tell my father? I won't say anything. Really? Really? There's no way I would. Alright then. What? Nothing. Could you pet- Okay. What? Is it not allowed? Well, I don't mind. Alright. Hands off. Charlotte. Yes? Are you on my side or are you on their side? You're either with me or against me. Why do you even ask? Of course I'm on your side. I see. Yes. Alright, that was really weird on all fronts. Young master. What is it? I brought the bread I got today. Are cats allowed to have bread? Could I give it to Chloé? Yeah, sure. She's so cute. Slow pan over to Pierre. I've already made up my mind on the moral compass of the scenario, okay? I have a bad feeling. Chloé. Oh, scary music. Chloé. Generic scary music. Where are you, Chloé? The little piano thing, right? Why aren't you here? Chloé. Have you seen Chloé? Charlotte, do you know Chloé? You know something, don't you? I mean, what should I do? Did you? Young master, the master, Chloé, then I. You killed Chloé. I didn't kill her. I could never. Oh, you didn't kill her, alright. I left her in the mountains. The master ordered me. You what? In those empty mountains, how could you? That's more or less killing her. But I didn't know where I'd go if I was removed from this house. I guess it was her or her. I love this house. This house with the master, the young master. It's my fault. I gave her a half-hearted name, I fed her. It's not like I could keep her. It's my responsibility. Literally, just play the violin for your cat. You know, your hands look like this so her paws can look like that. I killed Chloé. This is still kind of weird. Why did we pick Chloé, huh? No, master, you're not at fault. Huh? You've done nothing wrong. The one in the wrong is... Uh-oh. Is young master Pierre. Huh. The one who told master about Chloé was young master Pierre. Nice RPG sound there. Remember that, I think, from Pocket Mirror. That's why he's responsible for everything. Ooh, I don't know if I believe that. Actually, I rescind everything I just said. I'm a little hesitant, just missed that line, but... Control's out of my hands. Pierre. But... In that case, even you. Damn. Why did this? Never mind. It's fine. Even though we're twins. Even though we're twins, why are we so different? What are we gonna be doing now? Ah, young master. Right, what are we doing? Father. What is it, Michel? I don't want to do the performance. What are you saying, Michel? There's no way I can allow that. But... No, I can't cancel. I don't want to. I don't want to do it. Michel, just who do you think I am? I am your father. If I feel like it, I am entirely capable of moving you from this house. Of removing you from this house. Listen to what I'm saying. Farewell. You're a troublesome one. What? Yeah, that's right. You've always been unreasonable, honestly. How long can we use you? There's no way of knowing. Once child prodigy hits 20, they become like any other person. I need to use you while I can. You got a long way to go. That's 9 whole years. What are you worried about? I don't even have that kind of stability right now. Well, that's how it is. Pierre isn't the only one with parents who don't love him. I was simply something to be used. Why did I have to be used by that bastard? I wish I never started playing violin. That was the main problem. I hate it. Young master. Did something happen with the master? Don't worry about me. Please feel better. Thanks. Did something happen to the master? Did he point out that you've been in a slump for a while? Man, my screen's turning red. It is fine. I believe in your talent, young master. You do not have to do the impossible. It is young master Pierre's fault that he struggles with so much. I'm sure that if you practice a lot, the master and others will realize your skill, young master. What is going on? Shut up. Who would do anything for him? What do you even know? Whoa, what's going on around here? Huh? Young master. Uh-oh. Accidental death. How did that even happen? Literally how? Did I do that? What do you mean, did you do this? Dropping a chandelier? No, it wasn't kind of like Scooby-Doo chase nonsense is this? The old chandelier was brittle anyway. What kind of like fighting game Sleeping Dogs finisher? But I was the one that pushed her, wasn't I? It's alright. It's fine that I killed her. Good. Let the hate flow through you. She was an eyesore anyway. Killing someone isn't that a big deal. Is it that big a deal? Lives can be snuffed out in an instant. You're literally 11. You should be eating dirt. Yeah, it's not that big of a deal. You should be catching every disease known to man in a classroom. I did nothing wrong. You're like, lives can be snuffed out in an instant. Okay, well, you know what? You just stopped watching Barney the Dinosaur last year, okay? Cool it. A little warhawk over here. And now we're killing cats. Okay, young Patrick Bateman. Feed the ATM a stray cat. Literally relax. At the beginning of the game, did we see a white cat meow at us here? Charlotte's corpse had been placed in such a way that it seemed like she had died on accident, caused by a chandelier falling, which is probably the reality. I do not know anything. I did not do anything. No one doubted me. My nightly bloodlust has spilled into my days. Even after a year, nothing changed with Charlotte and Pierre. What? Chloé. I'm the worst. Yes, you are. Even though I knew, you're human. You're just as innocent, just like the other Chloé is. That's why. I thought my Chloé had become human and had returned. You are literally 11. Okay, I don't know. I really thought that. But I was wrong. Chloe's the same as me, isn't she? A human just like me. You've got to be the dumbest kid alive. Why did I, until now, be like, oh, she's a cat? I have the two confused. It's so rude to both of you, to that Chloé and this Chloé. One was literally a cat. Chloé isn't a cat, she's human. She's simply a normal girl who is burdened with a sad curse. What are you talking about? My Chloé is dead. She won't be coming back. This, like, went from 0 to 100 real fast, and there's no one at the wheel. I have to accept it. Anyhow, purifying. Got a little achievement, and it's all red and everything. Probably will show up in the recording. Honestly, some Arthur or some Reading Rainbow would fix you. What is wrong? I hate the violin. Because of that, a lot of bad things happened. You've been through a lot too, haven't you? Me too. A lot of bad things happen. That is why I despise myself. We need something in common. I wonder. Maybe we're both selfish. Yeah. That's why we can't leave it alone. Strangely enough, I didn't mind my performance here. I wonder if it's because you were my only audience. I'm not sure. That is strange. But your performance before was your best yet. Thank you, Michel. By the way, I always feel better when you perform. Like the curse is lifted a little bit. That is not because you are a skilled performer. It is because it is you, Michel. That is why I love your performances. I see. I believe she can hear them too. Not long left. Not long until. I see. Wait, who? Oh, there's something going on here. What is this? Obtain the key for second floor hallway. What floor are we on? Curse lifted because you, Michelle. Okay, not an answer. Hello? Oh, this room, right? Alright, nothing good's gonna happen here, right? Second floor stuffed toy. That chandelier's gonna fall. I know it. Painting of a woman. Red handprint. Oh, a trapdoor. First floor passage. Gee, 4 o'clock. There's a lot of blood around here. I think that's a tad concerning. What's this? It feels like someone is behind me. I don't see anyone. Oh, a kitty. Oh, now you meow. Oh, Blanc doesn't. That's why. I'll put your hand in the hole. Basement storage room key. Who is phone? Hello? There's a notebook. Oh, I need a pen. Will this do? Oh, this looks like a puzzle. Just not gonna think about that. Okay. Well, I guess we have a pen now. Oh, numbers. Okay. 6, 3, 2, 1. 1. 7, 2. The ink ran out. Numbers memo. Well, at least I didn't... I suppose I didn't have to write that down, but... wouldn't hurt. Okay, I'm sure... this will come into play here. Don't play. Do is one. Oh, do is one. And Baba is you? Oh, wait. Okay, so that is... do. Mi, fa, sol, la. I can't remember the last one. Is it like, T? And then do again. So that's 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Got it. Should have paid closer attention when they were making us watch Sound of Music in high school here. Okay, so 6 is la, and then 3 is mi, which is D, and 2 is re, that's S, and then 1 is do, that's A, and then another do, and then T, which is that, and then a 2, which is S. You can do it. I'll give you credit for it. Hey, I wonder if you were pleased by my phone call. I like it. Oh, really? I'm glad. I'm quite into you. So... I'll lock it up for you. Okay. Wow. Oh, wow. Variety of items. Okay. One time I noticed that the awful me had been afflicted with a curse. Curse? It was too late when I noticed I had already fallen into the depths by that point. Deep in the darkness, the curse separated from me and changed into the body of a cat. The black cat is me, the white cat is the curse. The cursed cat can't meow, just like how I was when I was cursed. I understood that in order to cut off the curse, I had to kill the white cat with my own hands. Small bell. It was written in a book that the only way to do it was to fight with the white cat, so I attached it to myself. The book ends here. Gotta kill a cat, huh? I wanna leave. Okay. Uh-oh. Okay, wait. What else could they humanly question me on? So this is C, dur. And then 4-4 is the tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, da, 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 da. Got it. All right. Be like, what is the average velocity of a swallow? Try a little harder. This is why I didn't do music when I was younger. 10 Okay, next one. Xylophone. music theory class over here. There's a music sheet on this floor somewhere. Go look for it. Say what? Music sheet. This is the different noise that running versus walking makes. Okay, well, there's a piano. I feel like these flowers has something to do with a puzzle, but I don't know how to read music. Oh, that is the music, isn't it? Alright, the room itself is a music sheet. Okay, I get it, I'll let you out now. Cool, go kill cat. How boring. Why are you here? I was thrown away. A long time ago, that girl used to play me a lot. Then one day, I jammed her fingers, all so suddenly. When she closed me, her hand slipped. Thus, I am now like this. It's not my fault, and yet I was the one who was thrown away. Really, it's not easy being an instrument. You got that right. You're right. We end up always putting the blame on the instruments. Maybe the real monster was not the violin, but me. Well, this has nothing to do with you, so it's whatever, really. I'll even give you this, so make sure to do your absolute best. Basement storage room key, south. Lovely. Okay. Supposed to see you about a bell. I'm supposed to fight with you. Where am I? You're in Silent Hill now, son. What do you like, Michel? As for food, I guess I like sweets. Rather, I don't eat anything other than sweet things. That is right. You love sweets. I like sweets because they are delicious. Is there anything else you like? The souls of the innocent. A bagel. I like music and you. I didn't mean like that. Okay, I get it. What's going on? The mold over here. What? Is that evil Chloé? Well, that totally is. Again, we meet again. Hey. Why are you... Charlotte? Uh-oh. That's chase music. I'm not ready. Young Master Michel. You get chandeliered again? Oh yeah, where are you? Why did you follow me here? I hate everything, so I ran away. It's impossible. There's no way you can just run away. I will always, always, no matter where, follow you, young master. I shall pray for your eternal soul. Ever since that day, you killed me. That's up for debate. I think that's debatable. Did you know? Fun fact, did you know everything you have done since coming here? I saw all of it. I was always near you. That night, when returning from the concert, when your father scolded you. Right, young master Michel? Alright, you get a upbeat, TikTok-y voice now. Is this like the murderous rampage that we were on earlier? Michel, what do you want to- What are we doing? Beating him to death with hammers? Huh? Young master, where are you going? Hey, children shouldn't be out at this time. Hey, young master Michel, I will notify the master- Oh, we did go on a killing rampage. Tonight, there was an incident resulting in an injury at a certain household. The offender was 12-year-old Michel Dardan. The victims were his father and two maids working at the household. The offender is still on the run, and his whereabouts are unknown. According to a driver, he went to a noble manor where a murder had recently taken place. Hold on. That's news to me. Who got killed around here? Hey, did you really think you could escape? That father of yours, there's no way he'd change his mind, right? Pierre is going to be in for a shock when he wakes up. Lol. He won't forgive you. Who are you? Me? I am... Young Master Michel. I am your curse. Oh, how considerate. Michel, you look so sad. What was it again? Too strong a hatred will eventually take form? Chloe. Oh my god, let's be cursed together. You weren't the only one affected by the curse. I was affected too. Up until now, there's been so many hardships. I no longer know what to do. Play the violin. I've come to dislike just about everything. Thus, I ended up doing something irreversible. I ran away, and then I ended up here. A little spelling thing there. I knew from the moment I first met you. I'm good at recognizing stuff like that. After all, I am also a murderer. I see. Chloe. Let's look for the music sheet. That is all I can do right now. Oh, this is the final piece, huh? Let's just leave everything else. Thanks to you, the curse was lifted. Okay. I don't think we're quite there yet. There might be one more piece to go. A little dress here. Got a bust. Some notes. Absolutely nothing that is giving me a prompt. This go? First of all, courtyard. Oh, the cats are up there. How do I leave you? Nocturne number 20. Okay. Right. Oh wait, there's another one over here. Oh, Chopin. Nocturne is a song that reminds one of a good night at a party. I'll be the judge of that. This doesn't sound like that good of a night to me. Maybe nights were just different back then. What's going on? Are you performing with me tomorrow? Yes, I am. Oh, I see. I am Michel de Lambert. Nice to meet you. Chloé Ardon. Chloé, huh? Quite different. Nice to meet you too. So we didn't know each other. Go ahead. Chloé, please come to my room. Wait a minute. She's going to rehearse with me soon, so please don't take her with you. I see. Okay, then. Alright. I'm surprised that worked. Okay, so this is the song that was playing earlier. This part, I buy, reminds you of a party, but the intro, not quite. It's very, very somber and stiff opening to that party. Alright, let's perform and get the rehearsal done. Why? What do you mean, why? What just happened with my father? Well, you didn't look best pleased. Plus, I just want to get this rehearsal over and done with. I don't really want him making it take longer. It's sorted, so let's begin. You have your piano ready, right? Yeah. Alright, here we go. By the way, if you just keep putting up with stuff, I won't continue with you. You'll end up like him. I did not have to go with my father when he summoned me. Thanks to him. Then he saved me. He said he was worried about me. His performance. It is so sorrowful. I felt like it resonated with me deeply. I feel much better when I'm performing with him. I feel as if I've been rescued from my father. Right, so let's talk about the murder. So I fell in love with his performances. Good work. You too. Could I, hold your hand? Yeah, I guess. Why? The twisted musician over here. Thank you. Oh, what for? For giving me strength. Good work. Well, my parents are waiting for me, so I shall be leaving. Wait. What is it? I wonder if we'll be able to meet again. Who knows? I would like to meet with you again. Did you call me here? Did your soul, desiring so deeply, call me to your manor? Chloé. That'll be the first and last time that you run away from me. So I, Michel. Save me, Michelle. Okay, so the murder was her. Highly regrettable. Chloé, I finished a new song. I made this song for you. And the title is Chloé's Requiem. Requiem? Father, I'm still alive. Why? I'm going to die. That feel when the music foreshadows your imminent demise. Oh? This could really go in multiple ways. Okay. Oh, I think we saw the sprite earlier, too. The curse. The curse that ate away at me. Finally took me whole. I can no longer return. I'll have to look. That was actually my alternate thumbnail choice, aside from zoomed in Chloé. The curse has a mind of its own. It has chased away my sense of self. All I could wish for was help. Okay, so your longing did bring me here. Michel, please stop the curse. Save me. That is my final wish. Change the world, my final message. Goodbye. Do we get the courtyard too? I mean, this part's brighter, but... Oh, there we go. Looks okay. Played Nocturne number 20 with Chloé. Michel. You might not remember, but we performed together once, long ago. Performed together? Oh, wait, were you? Chloé Ardan, yes. But you're like a completely different person. I didn't realize. That is true, but I'm the old Chloé. I've been waiting for you, Michel, ever since that time. You were my sole light. That is why I am able to be here. You really came for me. I'm not the real Chloé. The real Chloé, the Chloé that was alive, was consumed by the curse. I am what remains of her. I guess I am kind of like her ghost. That is why I am unable to leave the manor, so I thought I needed help. By the way, I was the one who called you here. Who would have guessed it? You are the only one who can lift the curse. I know it is a lot to ask. I am sorry. You know, it's not as big of a deal as you make it out to be. Even I'm cursed. I can't do anything about it. Let's lift our curses together! But you thought of me as human. I wonder if that's why. I don't even know what I think about you. I want to save you. Thank you. One soul for three. Fair trade? Here. A silver knife. What is... Use that to kill Chloé. It's the only way. What? What do you mean? The real Chloé. Ever since that day, she has not eaten for days. She's been able to rest as she no longer has a body. At least, until dawn. Until dawn! She'll die when the sun rises. Never played that game. But if Chloé dies of the curse, she'll become a vengeful spirit. Just like when you came to the manor. No, in fact, even worse. The manor itself is cursed. It wrought so much trouble for so many. I hate that. Please. Are you not able to survive? Even if I were to survive, I would no longer be able to return to being Chloé. The outcome is the same. Michel, being with you like this, performing together, it reminded me of that time. It purged the manor's curse just a little. I'm so happy. It is all thanks to you, Michel, so... what's going on? I hope we can transform your curse into love and purify this manor. Hawa? Oh, we get a little kiss. Well, Kif, I pray, I think. Michel, I love your performances, so I beg. Please do not hit yourself or the violin. You are not allowed to be cursed. Chloe, your body. It is almost dawn. Behind the red fruit tree, the real Chloe lies there, as well as the source of the curse. I'm sorry, Michel, I made you the bad guy. What's this all of a sudden? She gonna vanish? Oh, she did vanish! The curse, huh? Alright, we got some choices here, I think. First, do I have an option? I cannot. Behind the red fruit tree. Found a staircase. Oh. Secret passage. There is a corpse. There's also a corpse. There's a skull. I'm trying to eat something. Cello. Huh? Who is... Oh, man. Who is Cello again? Okay. Pianos. Numbers. Okay. Are you satisfied? You want my hand? Okay. I mean, sure, why not? Secret small room. A lot of dead bodies. Curse zero. Wait, what is this supposed to be? When a deep hatred forms with someone, it can eventually become a curse. As the curse strengthens, it consumes their heart, eventually erasing that person's sense of self entirely. The source of the curse, something deeply involved with the curse, can become the source of it. And there are cases where it resides in a person's heart. How to break the curse has yet to be discovered. However, there is a theory that the actions of a beloved one can lead to a miracle. Okay, so it's on us. We, like, knife the piano? Hey, kid. Oh, my mistake. You're Michel D'Alembert, right? It is nice to meet you. I am Chloe's curse. Curse. Oh yeah? Well, knife to meet you. Pleased to make your acquaintance. I jest. Because. You shall become my prey. Not if I can help it. So, like, what do I do in this scenario, huh? You and me. What do you think? Dual-wield hammer and knife. Nope. What am I supposed to be doing here? Just now. We can't run, we have to face it. Right, so like, what am I supposed to be doing though? What about this, huh? What on earth am I supposed to be doing? Oh, got cornered! Alright, that's it for me. We're done. Okay. I guess I had a last stand mode there. Right, let's get this Let's just get this little song and dance over with. Nothing personnel, kid. How about that, huh? Get hammered, idiot. Destroyed the piano. Hammer's broken. Well, that kind of worked. Chloe's father. Is this the main source of the curse? I don't think so. Then, if I destroy this, Chloe will be free. I guess it won't work. Key for hidden room. Beyond here. What should I do with a knife? It's time to decide. Can I save first? You bet I can. Can I get the white cat? Can I get Blanc? Because I heard, remember, a small bell? No, you won't. You don't even meow at me anymore. I thought we were friends. That's heartbreaking. You know, really, really, really breaks my heart that you won't meow at me anymore. Right. Well, what incomprehensible horrors wait beyond? Chloe, I... Oh, you're evil, Chloe. Oh, you're going insane. Oh, I took the weapon to Chloe. Oh, I get a choice here. All right, let's try this. Hold on. Chloe, were you saved? Oh boy, I sure hope so. I have no idea if you were happy, but I'm glad that I met you, really. It's almost morning. Hope this worked. I bet the cops are outside. I'm outside. This place has got a great view. I wonder why. It feels like it's been a long time since I was last outside. Hey, Chloe. You're no doubt exhausted, too. Let's take it easy. I'll head home in a little while. Everyone is probably looking for me. Goodbye, Chloe. Well, we got an ending. I don't know which one it is. I think I'm gonna hunt for a few endings here. Let's see. Why does the name Karen Ouyang feel so familiar? Thank you. Interesting that this was not translated by VG Person, as far as I know. Normal ending. Alright, that's tolerable, I suppose. Around the time she was yet to be consumed by... A year before a terrible incident. The night a young boy argued with his brother, running off crying. I'll talk about the other half of my life, which all began there. Oh, con amore. I think that's like a whole new game from my understanding. Right, let's have a quick look because I'm a cheater. And let's see what the ending guide says. Because if there's a true ending, it'd be pretty cool to check that out. Right, let's give this a try. What if I do not knife her? Because I looked at the requirements and it seems like I'm missing something crucial. But I don't think I have the ability to do it yet. Chloé. I picked Embrace, right? Ugh. No. Oh, did she kill me? Nope. This is similar to that time. I killed again. This time. Chloé. I did it again, just like that time. Break. The curse. Ugh. Oh, you look, thrilled. The end. Bad two. Okay, that did not pay dividends. Okay, how do I do this? Aha. Alright, I'm a cheater and I looked this up. I knew that I had one of the dolls in my inventory and I didn't quite figure out what it was for. And if you put that one and the one on the ground, on the sofa, you get a bell. Where did I come from? In here. And so, that bell, I think, should go on Noir? I'll read that again in a sec. But I have a bell. Let's see. I assume so. I only got one bell, and the note said it goes on the black cat, so you get a bell. Really? How come Blanc had the option, huh? What's the deal with that? Was there another bell? I'm gonna confess, this is my least favorite part about making certain Let's Plays, is when you mess up, and through the power of editing, as you will have seen right before this, you have to go back and play the entire game again because you missed a singular crucial step, like putting both the dolls on the sofa back in Chapter 2 and getting a bell and then putting it on Noir and then getting the blackened bell here. So that is what opens up another ending, but not the true ending. Blanc's bell. The dirt won't come off. I wonder if I can clean this bell somewhere. Where did I get this bell? Roger that. Well, let's do it. I think that I am in a position where I can get the remainder of the endings with some relative ease. We'll save over that spot. So I got one bad ending, and I think that was by embracing Chloe and not stabbing her. So the other bad ending is to push her. And then we have the true ending, which I accomplished by going back and getting the bell for Noir. And then the secret ending is acquired through getting Blanc's bell. So let's go ahead and do that, and then I will have the option to either use it or not, and that should open some doors for us. I'm on the wrong floor. I'm on the wrong floor again. Right. Oh hey, look at that. Hey. Hey, we're back. What's going on here? And the curse. Record the curse. The drawn curse. Burn. Stop talking. I think I burned my tenant joke in the last episode, so. Right, I'm cheating. So the diary is one item, and then the other one is the father's photo book. So both of you can go in the fire. And then we should get a purified bell. Right. I'll unequip these things. Burn some books. Alright. Thank you for waking me up. Why are you here? Didn't you already disappear? This manor's curse is starting to fade, so I was able to return it to how I used to be. Return to how I used to be. Then what about Chloe? Oh, that was the fire, okay. She. I never once thought that would be the best way of doing it. Disappearing like that. I want to help Chloe, too. There are two main curses in this manor. Let me borrow that bell. Pass the bell over to friend. The bell has been cleaned. She hasn't completely disappeared. She's locked within her own shell. She simply isn't showing herself to you. Alright, Phasmophobia. I'm gonna call the demon to us. You'll need this to help her. Save Chloe. Save this manor. Understood. Clean bell. Superb. That has opened up all avenues to us. Let's go ahead and mosey back on over. I will say, after... Here, let me bring up recording software. After the last, 45 minutes or so of replaying the game from Chapter 2, I did realize that a lot of the weird dialogue in, the part where we get possessed by the father, thereabouts, a lot of that weird dialogue was kind of based on the idea that Chloe was the cat and not human Chloe. So there are certain lines like, oh, I killed Chloe and I need to see one more time, da da da. That made a lot more sense in context because it was just him like, oh, I don't believe that this this girl that I'm talking to in this haunted mansion is not my reincarnated cat. So that was weird, but it do be like that. Okay, I think I'm gonna do the bad ending, and then we'll do the true ending, and then let's do the secret ending last. You piano. Sometimes it's weird that some of these prompts are, they default to nothing. Okay. Right, let's, dual wield. I know the hammer is the useful weapon here, but, Elaine, may thy knife chip and shatter. So you can come on over here. Haha, idiot. Get juked. That's right, I'm smashing your physical manifestation of the curse, and there's nothing you can do to stop me. Roger that. Okay. Next up, bad ending. No, the guide has the numbers on here that this should be number... Is this number two or number one? Let's see. That this is number two. But I think my achievement was the other way around, where when I embraced her, that gave me bad end too. But I could be... I stand corrected if that's the, that's the case. You know, as intimidating as that CG is supposed to look, I just can't bring myself to use that as the thumbnail, so I'll have to do something else. Push away? Yeah, that's right. Judo throw. Unless I did that before. I thought I embraced her. Oh wait, did I mess up and I accidentally hit push and not embrace before? Alright, well, surprise! It's bad end two again. We'll get back. Right back after this, this jump cut to bad end one, I realized something. I messed up. This is actually going to give me the true end, because the bell is on noir. So, foiled once more, but... Just kidding, after the cut came the true end, apparently, and not bad end one, but we'll get back to that. Just have to go wrangle my save from last night when I did the majority of this recording. Alright, don't swing down the knife. And then we will embrace you. Oh, bring it in, bring it in. I will. With power of love, I can't use the knife. I can't kill you, Chloe. I've lost one Chloe. I can't lose another. Ow. It hurts, Chloe. The keepsake. Chloe. Oh, I guess that's a question mark. Chloe? Okay. We gotta speed up these dots a little bit here. Staying alive. Heard that scream before. Chloe. Going on out there? I heard the bell. Cat fight. Noir. What happened? How did you get injured? Alright, we gotta speed this up a little bit, Michelle. Was that what that noise was? Blanc is alive? Did you... with Blanc? For whom the bell tolls. Oh, gone again. Ugh. I see. You. Chloé. Michel. Huh? Hey, how you feeling? Where? Oh, don't say it. Do you know who I am? Michel. Is it really you, Michel? Okay, good. I was worried we were gonna break into a where am I? Yeah, Chloé. We came for you after all. We finally meet. Well, we meet again, right? I have always waited for this moment, Michel. Yeah. Hey, Michel. I want to see the sunrise. Okay, got it. Well, we need to get her up the stairs and everything. It's such a lovely view, isn't it, Chloé? It feels like it's been a long time since we saw this view. It's a pretty sick view. I stand by that. It does. Chloé. A lot happened, didn't it? Things we want to forget. Painful things. Things that just makes us want to run away. Controlled by the curse, we struggled so much. Hey, Chloé. Was your life an unhappy one? I think we know the answer to that. It's pretty, Michel. Until now, I thought that life was just full of bad things. But now, being able to be here with this pretty view, I am happy. So happy. I see. I'm glad. Michel. Okay, this is solid thumbnail content right here. The sun is rising. The night is coming to an end. Oh, we're just gonna leave her there. Oh, she's just sleeping. It's okay. Rest in peace. Requiescat in pace. Thanks to you, I was able to enjoy playing the violin for the first time ever. That's why. Chloé's Requiem. I'm going to look too. I already said no. It is dangerous for a child to go alone. But then, when are you going to find Michel? Is he safe? He could be injured, or worse, playing the violin. Is he even alive? If something has happened to him, I'll... Calm down. We're doing this so that isn't the case. Okay. Graphic violins. God, I beg you. Please save my brother Michel. And we had a hand in doing this to ourselves. I didn't even get to apologize to him. I chased him out. Michel. I'll return home after a little while. And what, go to jail? No doubt a lot of people are looking for me. I can't reverse what I've done, but I can't run away from it. I have to properly redeem myself. Even if they never forgive me, I'll talk about what happened to Charlotte, and Father, and the maid. I'll apologize to Pierre. Acceptance. That's no doubt what Chloe wanted. Roll credits. Yeah, I guess this is the best ending then. We've come to terms with our deeds, our misdeeds. Voice actor. You know, I was questioning that, because I know that there were a few sounds. On the phone, and then earlier when I think Chloe was getting hit, and was saying it's painful, and then Elaine laughing. The end. And true. Good night, Chloe. Around time she's yet to be consumed by a year before terrible. Okay, this is opening up Con Amore. I think we'll split Con Amore into a different video. But with that, let us go ahead here and do a bad end. Oh wait, this was a save that I had already beat Elaine. What about earlier? Surely here. Okay. Alright, here I come. May thy knife chip and shatter. I'm trying to make up for the fact that I didn't really have any John Wick references in this, really. So we'll do the most recent movie that kind of stunned me, which is Dune 2. Okay, yeah. How about you come right over here and get stuck on this table? Well, he's coming to me. Sneaking a few more hits. So, I didn't get a chance to comment on it because I didn't catch him in a good spot, but that laughing that just played definitely sounded like maybe a voice actor that was a little too young for the character that they were trying to portray. Or most certainly not conveying the age, because show me an old man that laughs like that and I'll be freaked out adequately. Roger that. Okay, let's go get bad end one, and then we will get the secret ending. Okay. So, I need to embrace you. I'm going insane up in here. Oh, I think I know what happened is I thought I was tabbing down to embrace, but this game defaults me to slot 0, I guess, and so when I hit down twice, it brought me down to push. Oh, we got stabbed. Chloé. Chloé, you don't have to be afraid. That is a huge knife. But with that said, that means that it was taken from the entry hall when we saw it earlier. I was being all pissy at the beginning. Like, oh, let me get a sword. I'm not going to hurt you with a knife. Literally, like, what's it, Commando, you want to put a knife in me. Not the curse or anything. I'll change the fact that you are who you are. Or will change the fact. I can't kill. But I can be killed. It's okay. Although props for them for doing the little, like, gurgling blood there. You don't need to be afraid anymore. I'll always be with you. Well, death is about to do us part real soon, so... Hey. So please. Don't cry, Chloé. Meh. Oh, come on, you're almost there. Like, taking your first steps all over again. Michel. I think we're missing an L there. This is Michel. The end. Bad one. Well, cool. Let's go ahead. I wonder... We'll give this one a try. Let's even put the bell on Blanc. Because I have the bell. And then... I think, according to my handy-dandy Steam community cheat sheet here, I will put the bell on Blanc and then get killed by Alain. Alright, have fun. I find that bell rather appealing. Don't lick my face, it's tickly. Oh, I got a little... Man, I gotta get killed by Alain. This is, gave me one extra health for him to take away. Chloe's past memories. I should be relieved. I was glad I could hear Michelle's performance in the end. Yet, why is my heart feeling so empty? Chloé. Michel? Why are you here? Let's get out of here. No. Why? I don't want to hurt anymore. Chloé. At first, I found you a little annoying. You were selfish, annoying, stubborn, a little stupid. Okay. Dial it back, dude. That's no way to talk to a lady. It felt like I was looking at a reflection of myself. But Chloé, as I learned more about you, I thought I wanted to help you. I don't want you to run away. You can't run away. Oh, so this is like the good Chloé that presented herself to us through the house. It's almost morning, Chloé. I'll also do my best, so do your best too, until the end. I really, really... So, Chloé. Okay. Michel. The curse is really close, but it seems that I can move around in this room somewhat. Chloé. Let's go, Chloé. Long laughed a little. Noir, you are so cute today. Oh, a little kitty cat. So what is the purpose of this? Let's save. Oh, wait. Aw, I thought that Chloé was gonna be in my party. I have to get killed by Elaine here? That's interesting. Gone again. Well. Who goes there? Okay. I will give them credit. The more I read this scene, I really enjoy his terseness here. He's just like, I'm Chloe's curse, prepare to die. Or he's like, nice to meet you, just kidding, prepare to die. Okay, we're gonna do a little loop-si-loop here while I point out. I feel like this is a little too youthful, you know? This gives me a recollection from when Mermaid Swamp came out, or the remaster Mermaid Swamp came out. You definitely had someone who was playing an old lady who was pretending to be an old lady. A little bit of that. That was a little too youthful. Elaine Ardan, huh? Then. Oh, I'm fading! Ugh. Michel. Okay, this is new. Michel. Huh? This dude dropped the where am I? Where am I? I'm sorry, because of my father. What? Michel, you met the same fate as me. Did I die? Is this the afterlife? Am I going to get to meet Jennifer Love Hewitt? Noir died too? Noir too. It is all my fault. I'm sorry. Actually, this is better. We'll be like this forever, you know? That sounds quite fun, don't you think? Michel. Literally, the silver lining to dying. You literally just saw the silver lining to death. Hey, Chloe. You know, there's something I always wanted to do. Playing the piano together. Okay. We're about to crank the hauntedness of this house up to 11. Dedicated to the manor that fell victim to a curse. Is it me or does Chloe's sprite seem a little smaller than before? Okay, this is the Requiem. Don't mind me, just Googling Karen O. Yang. All doctors. Chamber music. And I hit there. Oh well. Guess I didn't need to know about that anyways. This is a very interesting ending, I will say. Michel was not bothered about dying. Didn't really seem all too bothered by it, quite frankly. Okay, let's see. An empty, cursed manor. stands silent. Oh, pretty loud to me. Am I controlling the aim? What's going on? To this day, pleasant music can still be heard coming from the manor. I was gonna say, that really, ooh, perfect cherry on top. I was like, we could use a little haunted house. Okay, ending ghost. Use a little haunted house angle, you know? Perfect. Okay, we're gonna pitch Connemore again. Okay, I think I'm just gonna give thoughts here. From what I understand, Connemore is like a complete addition to this game. It's like a whole other little, I don't know, mini game, short tie-in story. I think it's about the cats. But I want to kind of assess Chloe's Requiem on its own before I move on and play Connemore, which will be coming soon. Might take a break to cover a new game in between that first, but otherwise, I'll get around to it in the near future here, barring that nothing, no other unpleasant surprises are thrown at me by life. But overall, what else was I gonna say, but I really did like this game. It bears resemblance to another game that I really enjoyed a while ago. I got a little bit of Arya's story in here, obviously, and I think this game certainly predates it, if I'm remembering correctly. But I really did enjoy that kind of angle of, you know, towards the end, it becomes very heavy-handed that, you know, Chloe's dead, and you're kind of talking to this very positive reconstruction of Chloe, who, you know, did not meet a particularly pleasant fate. But, you know, just kind of judging the game for what it is, I enjoyed the story, the musical theme, as you listen to me struggle through recognizing pieces here and there and, you know, misidentifying notes during my first take at the locked piano room puzzle. That was quite good. I generally enjoy monster stories a bit more. I know that in this case, Alain and the curse were the monsters is a little, you know, it was a little heavy and was laid on pretty thick at some points, like with all the Chloe beating going on. But that was all in all part of the experience. I saw really briefly some footage of the original, and this is miles ahead of what the original one looked like, so I have zero complaints. Graphics were fantastic, game handled fairly well, the music is good, assuming that I don't get any content ID claims on it and get someone else monetizing the video. The only thing that really began standing out more and more as we played, I feel like the English translation could have used a little more polishing. There are definitely some moments, some grammatical, some spelling, and I think sometimes you had a little bit of a UI problem where certain lines were getting cut off on the right-hand side of the text box, but, you know, overall, I guess for a paid game, it certainly was not worse than what Noelle the Mortal Fate released as in its initial state, so can't really complain about that. And, realistically, it's kind of like two games in one, because we also have a little more in Connemore, which will not be within the scope of this particular video. So I'm just going to end it here. That one will follow up. I'll pick up in a separate recording. I'll find it all. I'll probably put it all within the same playlist, but anyhow. Good experience overall, worth following up on after all these years, and, you know, I don't feel like it got as much recognition as the other big names, and maybe the kind of original jankiness of the original release might have contributed to that, but very solid entry in that kind of era of early RPG Maker. Certainly more, assuming that things are, you know, approximately the same, certainly more direction than, say, Aoni, you know, definitely on par with even Witch's House in terms of sufficient depth of the story. I'm very pleased with that. I'm rambling, as usual, because it's the conclusion. I never really script these things. I don't do, like, a pro-con analysis, just whatever comes to mind, and it was good music. Sometimes a little rough around some edges here and there, but overall very pleasant experience with a good story, and just enough of red text to teach us all that the lesson of RPG Maker horror games is not to trust people. who speak in red text and never make any promises. That's been your PSA, and we're just gonna end the video here. So thank you all for watching this. I'll see you again soon, hopefully, in Konamori. And with that, have a wonderful rest of your day or night, depending on when you're watching this video. Take care, and do try really hard to not argue with people under really old chandeliers that lack support. That is all.